السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله، عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى أيضا: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher and protector. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, first and foremost, I enjoin upon myself and all of you are seated here to adopt a life of taqwa, a life filled with the fear and the consciousness of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all moments and at all circumstances. And secondly, it is incumbent upon us to thank Almighty Allah for all of the blessings and bounties that He has bestowed upon us, and especially in regard to the bounty of this noble and blessed day. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu an, خَيْرُ يَوْمٍ طَلَعَتْ عَلَيْهِ الشَّمْسُ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ فِيهِ خُلِقَ آدَمُ وَفِيهِ أُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ وَفِيهِ أُخْرِجَ مِنْهِ. The best of days, the best of days upon which the sun has risen is the day of Jum'ah, is Friday. It was on this very noble and blessed day our noble father Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was created. And likewise, it was on this day that he was admitted entry into Jannah. And likewise, it was on this day Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was taken out of Jannah and sent to this world. So it is incumbent upon us to thank Almighty Allah for this blessed day that He has blessed us with. And I thank Almighty Allah for blessing me with an opportunity to discuss a few things with you all. So inshallah ta'ala, today's lecture is going to be a reminder about an unexpected guest. A guest who is about to visit us soon, who is going to come unannounced, without a notice or without an invitation. And it is none other than the stark reality of death, al-maut. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, أكثروا ذكر هادم اللذات. أكثروا ذكر هادم اللذات. Increase the remembrance or the mention of the destroyer of pleasures. أكثروا ذكر هادم اللذات. Our Salafun al-Salih, our pious predecessors, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, they used to advise their students, they used to advise their congregations, as to make death your slogan. Make death your slogan. For remember, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, this life that Allah the Almighty has blessed us with, the life of dunya, is not something that we are supposed to love or latch ourselves onto. It is not something we are supposed to love. The temporary and transitory life of this dunya that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with is something that we need to live and get over with. For if we internalize this concept, no problem, no affliction, no trial that we are afflicted with would look great for us. All of that would be trivial. Why? Because the happiness of this life is short-lived. The sadness of this life is short-lived. The problems of this life are short-lived. Nothing is permanent. All of it is temporary. Temporary. It is a transitory stage that Allah the Almighty has blessed us so that we may prepare ourselves for our destination, which is Al-Akhirah. Which is Al-Akhirah. So before we move on further onto death, there are two things that I wish to highlight. And they are in regard to Iman and Taqwa. Iman and Taqwa. For my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, it is only through these two that one can start climbing the stages of Wilayah. Allahu Akbar. It is only through these two. It is not only with Iman and not only with Taqwa, but rather with Iman together. A slave of Allah can start climbing the stages of Wilayah and attain the wilayah of Allah, become a friend of Allah. So what is Iman? What is Iman? Iman is قَوْلٌ بِاللِّسَانِ تَصْدِيقٌ بِالْجِنَانِ أَوْ بِالْقَلْبِ and عَمَلٌ بِالْأَرْكَانِ. It is not sufficient enough for you to say, I believe in Allah and not pray, not do a'mal. And it is not sufficient for you to utter the kalima but not have the belief in your heart. What in your heart about Allah, about the six articles of faith? Three things. Qawlun bil lisan. You are supposed to utter the statement with your tongue, the shahada. Number two, the firm and belief has to be grounded in your heart. It has to be grounded in your heart. And thirdly, these two combined would bring about the fruits of a'mal through your limbs. Through your limbs. So Iman, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, is أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله وباليوم الآخر وبالقدر خيره وشره. To believe in Allah the Almighty, that He is your creator. To believe in the angels of Allah. To believe in the messengers of Allah, the books, the revelations of Allah, the final day, the day of judgment, reality that is headed to us very soon. And finally, to believe in Qadr, the destiny and the fate, the Qadr of Allah the Almighty, the decree of Allah the Almighty, that good and evil is from it. This is Iman, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. So the minute a person fulfills the criteria that brings him within the fold of Iman, he becomes a mu'min. But when does he start becoming a wali from the awliya of Allah? May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from his awliya. A question that we need to ask ourselves often. Are we the friends of Allah or are we the friends of Shaytan the accursed? Are we the friends of Allah or are we the friends of Shaytan? For my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Shaytan the accursed is not a buddy that you want to take. He is not a friend. He is an artful, mischievous, cunning, sly enemy, a sworn race. He is a sworn enemy to mankind. He is someone who will cheat you, who will deceive you. And at the last minute, on the day of Qiyamah, in front of Allah, He will say, أَنَا بَرِيءٌ مِّنْكُمْ. I am free of you people. These are all your decisions. These are all your a'mal. This is what you earned. And now you face the consequences. This is what Shaytan would do at the last minute. He runs, fi majra dam. He runs wherever blood runs in our body. in the veins. He runs wherever. Shaitan, the people of taqwa, need to study the traps of shaitan. For the traps of shaitan are far and widespread today. He runs in the majra dam, wherever blood runs, he studies you. He understands your weaknesses. He understands your weaknesses. He understands what you like. And that's how he pushes you towards sin. Just as how he did in the case of our beloved parents, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and Hawa alayhi salatu wasalam. What happened? When they were in Jannah, he studied them. And that's why he came and incited them towards that fruit, saying that if you eat this fruit, you will gain eternity. You will be able to live in this Jannah forever and ever. Why? Because he found out that this was a desire within the hearts of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and Hawa alayhi salatu wasalam. They loved the place so much that they wanted to stay there forever. They wanted to dwell there forever. So he studied them and incited them towards the sin accordingly. This is how deceitful shaitan is. So we do not want to make him our friend, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. So it is only through iman and taqwa a person becomes the wali of Allah. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, all of us, we believe in Allah. We believe in the six articles of faith. So naturally we believe in death. We believe in al-maut. But if you were to ask anybody, maybe that person does not believe in the books of Allah. Maybe he does not believe in the malaika of Allah. Maybe he does not believe in any of the messengers of Allah. Or for that matter, perhaps he does not believe in Allah himself. Allah save us all. But he cannot deny the stark reality of death. No one on this earth can deny death. The destroyer of pleasures. No one can deny it. For Malakul Maut is waiting for us, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. We need to, it is surprising. Our Salafun As-Salih, they used to say, it is surprising to see a person enjoying this dunya, living happily in this dunya, amassing wealth, amassing millions, building palaces, collecting cars. It is not haram. But still, our Salafun As-Salih, they used to say, it is amazing to see people doing all of this whilst the sword hanging over their necks. Allahu Akbar. The sword of death is hanging over your necks. It's just waiting for the command of Allah to fall. And when the command of Allah comes upon us, not a minute sooner, not a minute earlier, not a millisecond earlier, not a millisecond later, Malakul Maut will be there. And my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Malakul Maut does not care how rich you are. Malakul Maut does not care how powerful you are. Malakul Maut does not care how influential you are. Malakul Maut does not care about your influence, nor your affluence, nor your wealth, your power. To Malakul Maut, he comes out of Allah and he grasps and seizes your soul. This is the duty of Malakul Maut. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, hadith in Mustadrak al-Hakim, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith go along the lines of his words. He visited a grave and then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prays, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adabil qabr. Ya Allah, I seek refuge in you from the punishment, from the torment of the grave. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes on to describe the scene of death. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that when a good soul is about to leave this dunya, when a good soul is about to leave this dunya, may Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all good souls. Malakul Maut, he comes down and stands by the head of that soul. He stands by the head of the soul. And then the malaika who come with him, he has an army of soldiers. In the sense, soldiers, malaika of death, they all come and stand beside this soul. And then Malakul Maut, he looks at this peaceful, righteous slave of Allah. He's on his deathbed now. And he says, Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutma'inna. Ya Allah, make us all good souls. The Malakul Maut, he says, O righteous slave of Allah, O peaceful soul, come out from your body. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beautifully describes, just as how a drop of pure water flows out from a water skin. How easy is it for a drop of water to flow out from a water skin? This beautiful soul comes out from the body. And immediately the malaika rush to grab the soul. And they have brought with them a kafan, a shroud from Jannah, which emits fragrance after fragrance. A beautiful shroud with brocade and design and embroidery. They wrap this soul, this righteous soul in that shroud, and they take care that they do not hurt the soul. They take precaution, and all of them, they carry the soul towards the heavens. They carry the soul towards the heavens. They reach the first heaven. The malaika of the first heaven, they immediately cry out, Ya Allah, who is this beautiful soul? The fragrance is reaching us. Who is this beautiful soul? And the malaika, they say, they proclaim, It is so and so, the son of so and so. Allahu Akbar, may Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from that category. It is the son of so and so, the name is proclaimed in the first heaven. Second heaven, third heaven, fourth heaven. And they go on until they reach the seventh heaven. And then, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in the hadith, the words go along the lines that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is said that the angels who are with that soul, to return him back to his body, to return him back to his body, for minha khalaqnakum wa fiha nu'idukum wa minha nukhrijukum taratan ukhra. Why? Because that body has to return to the soil. It is from that soil that we created him from. He has to return to it, and from that very soil we will resurrect him. So the soul is then beautifully brought back to the body, and then the soul, the body is moved to the grave. We'll try to discuss that too. But now, there is a serious side to the hadith. Allahu Akbar. Allah save us all. If that soul is an evil soul, Malakul Maut comes and stands by the head of that soul. And then he screams, Oh bad soul, come out from your body. Then the malaika who are surrounding him, they will not look beautiful. They will look frightened. They will be scared. Then this soul, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, will come out from this body just as how if you put an iron rod. And that iron rod has forks of, or thorns of iron, and then you drag it out. Just imagine the pain. The pain will run through each and every that person's body, each and every nerve of his body. It will be as if you are pulling out a thorn, not a drop of water now, a thorn pulled out from his body. The soul will be extracted in such a harsh manner. It will be pulled out. As it comes out, a bad smell would fill the area. And then the malaika would take that soul and they won't wrap it in anything. They'll rush to the heavens. The first, due to the bad smell, they would say, Ooh, what is this evil soul that you are bringing up here? Who is this person? And then they will say, It is so and so, the cursed person, so and so, the son of so and so. May Almighty Allah save us all. And heaven after heaven, they'll travel until they reach the seventh heaven, and then their soul will be returned back to the body. And now we go on to the qabr, few minutes more. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, when the soul is laid in the qabr, when the body is laid in the qabr, two angels. If it is a righteous soul, two beautiful angels will come. They will question him. Beautifully he will answer these questions. And that qabr will be expanded. Some narrations say 70 cubits in length. Some narrations say until your eyes can see the distance. And then it will become a rawda from the rawda of Jannah. A garden from the gardens of Jannah. The smell, the fragrance of Jannah will come to him. And it will be said to him, you sleep like a newly wed. You sleep like a newly wed until Allah the Almighty declares the Qiyamah. But on the other hand, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, if that soul is an evil soul, Munkar and Nakir, these two angels, they will come down to the grave. Their eyes their voice will be so long that they will trample their hair. It will be so long. They will come to him with iron maces and they will question him, Man Rabbuk, who is your Lord? be able to answer because he did not bring in firm conviction. He did not bring in firm. It was only qawl bil lisan. He did not have tasdeeq bil zinan. He did not have the firm conviction grounded in his heart. They will ask him, man nabiyyuk, who is your prophet? But he will not be able to answer because complex to look like his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He did not adopt the life of his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So how to recognize his beloved Prophet? How the favorite foods of actors and actresses, but he does not know the lifestyle of his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Likewise, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, he would fail in all of the questions. And finally, it would be ordered that the qabr narrows itself so much to the extent that his ribs will close upon one another. It will be so tight, so constrained. He would scream out in pain, and that qabr will be made a pit from the pit of the hellfire. Allahu Akbar, Allah save us all. And he would wish that the day of Qiyamah not come, because he is terrified to meet his Creator. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with a beautiful death. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with a death that everyone around us would envy that death. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take away our souls beautifully whilst we are in sajda, whilst we are in prostration, the clothes